Well, brother and sister horse wranglers, together with a washed-up child actor and a heartbroken IT specialist, add them all together with a UFO, and you have Nope. It's the highly anticipated thriller from Oscar-winning filmmaker Jordan Peele, and Ange caught up with the cast ahead of the film's release.
It's big.
It's in the cloud.
It's the nightmarish cross between a classic Hollywood Western and a sci-fi thriller. Oscar-winning filmmaker Jordan Peele is back in the director's chair doing what he does best, terrifying film lovers.
Run, OJ! Run!
Reuniting with the actor who helped put him on the map in Get Out, Daniel Kaluuya stars alongside Kiki Palmer, Stephen Ewan and Brandon Perea in Nope. A supernatural spectacular about a rural community and its close encounters with a UFO.
We need the shot.
What shot?
The shot. The money shot. Undeniable, singular, the Oprah shot.
The Oprah shot?
Daniel and Kiki, congratulations on the film. Daniel, you first teamed up with Jordan Peele in Get Out, but this time Jordan wrote the role of OJ specifically for you. Did that add any pressure?
When you get a role in that way and you haven't auditioned, there's always a level of pressure because you're not going through the natural process of, like, going, oh, making decisions. But Jordan and me communicate at a level where we can actually interrogate that and look for it, and then I'll go, oh, no, this is really, like, suited to me and I think I'm right for it. And so then it's about honouring that. But there is a bit of pressure with the fact that it went straight.
Are you glad you can now put horseback riding on your CV?
Yeah, I am. I actually am. I can't even lie. I'm glad that it's on my CV. I can't front. I'm going to stunt for that.
We are at the world-famous Hollywood Boulevard. Oh, hey, ladies, how y'all doing?
Kiki, Nope gives us a whole new meaning to the final girl horror trope. What was the highlight of playing such a strong female lead?
Man, just how cool she is. I think she's the coolest character probably that I've ever played. We see her go through so many different personal journeys throughout the film. I just love the spirit of who the character is. I love the way she dresses. I mean, the journey of creating what that look was with the costumer and the hair. And, you know, when Jordan was like, this is the look. This is, you know, when we developed her, I just feel like she's so original yet very representative.
With the entire film set built from the ground up, Nope brings out-of-this-world horror to the dusty Californian desert.
What was your reaction when you first got to walk through these incredible sets?
The whole time, we were imagining what we thought it was going to look like, and so to finally actually see what it was, it surprised me in moments like, I didn't expect it to look like that, and wow, that, you know what I mean? To finally see what Jordan and, you know, our illustrator had designed, it's totally different.
Like, I did think the house was really impressive. Mm-hmm. I wanted to stay there. I didn't have running water. So I was like, I tried to do that.
I'm sure you. That is so you. You're tiptoe in the method waters.
I dabble methodically.
Right here, you are going to witness an absolute spectacle.
They built something really incredible. The thought and detail that went into everything. Jordan had an intention and a purpose for a lot of the specific things that were all in there, especially The Office had so much memorabilia from a movie that doesn't even exist, which is kind of crazy.
There's something out here.
And you're the only person in the world that can get it on film.
Did you get to keep anything from the set?
Jordan actually sent me something really cool. He sent me the Mad Magazine poster, which was awesome. But while we were filming, I kept pointing at things, asking if I could have that.
Maybe the red cowboy suit?
That would be awesome. That probably is off limits. There was this great San Francisco 49ers hat that I was like, ooh, I like that one.
Breakout star Brandon Perea rounds out the cast, making his feature film debut as a quick-witted tech guru, serving as the voice of reason.
Did you see a UFO in that cloud?
I saw it.
Holy hell.
Was it fun to play the comic relief in a horror film?
It's funny that he's the comic relief. That's great to hear.
You'll be getting a call from my supervisor asking how my service was.
5 stars, Angel, 5 stars.
And this was my first time to be able to display my comedic skills in acting. It's a lot of pressure to feel because I'm trying to be the funny person in a Jordan Peele movie. This is literally one of the funniest guys living, so it's It's a high-pressure moment.
You guys gonna tell me what's going on?
Hell no.
Is it true you originally thought you wouldn't get the role?
Yeah, there was a moment in the callback. Jordan was on Zoom, and I just remember him being like, man, this the character is so funny that you brought. It's just really different than what I wrote for. And he's like, so I'd have to rewrite the entire script in order to put you in this movie. And I was just like, dang, okay, it's probably not gonna happen then. And he's just like, but you know what? Never mind, I'm just gonna rewrite the whole movie. And I was like, what? He's like, yeah, you got the part. And then start crying, the whole nine of me crying, Jordan crying, and we're all just a little cry fest.
There's just certain things that are just gonna make us go, nope, done, out, I'm gone. But y'all can handle this, but I'm nope. I'm gonna be nope. I'm gonna be noping over there.
I think we pissed them off.
Yeah, they repainted your house. That's what
the world is today. When it comes to horror or the supernatural, what's your personal nope?
Oh yeah, ghosts. No ghosts. Anything that like my fist can go through, no thank you.
If I'm home alone and I hear some sort of knock, I'm not gonna grab the door. I'll wait for the door to be opened or something else. I'll lock my room door so I don't have to deal with that thing. Oh, nope. And I'll run away.
You know what? When they start dipping in the godly waters, you know what I mean? I'm like, wait a minute now. You know, let's not bring that into it. You know, I get a little spooked out by that. Like, all right now.
Tongues. When they start speaking in tongues, I'm like, I ain't got time for this. I ain't got time. I don't know what they're saying. I put the captions on. They don't know what they're saying. I'm like, nah.
Sink into the floor.
Wait.
Sink.
As we've seen in Get Out and Us, there's always a deeper meaning to a Jordan Peele film. What do you hope audiences take away from this one?
The genius of Jordan's films is that they're always usually a mirror up against us, maybe circling a specific theme or idea, but he seems to be kind of reflecting all of it back at us too. So hopefully the audience engages with this, maybe leaves with some questions, also leaves satisfied at watching a fun story and being taken on a ride. I hope it's a good time for everybody.
No.
Nope.
Hell no.